Hello, I'm Mike Beckett with MD Alignment, and I'm here to discuss tire wear and handling problems and how ProTrack can help you solve them. First of all, there's only two reasons you align a vehicle. One is to solve a tire wear problem, the other is to solve a handling problem. And the more you know about what causes tire wear and what causes handling, the more effective and professional you'll be at fixing it. So we spend more time teaching how to diagnose tire wear problems and handling problems than we do how to use our tools, because they're very simple. The number one tire wear problem on page one of your handout is feathered wear. We see this day after day all across the country. As you slide a tire sideways in contact with asphalt or concrete, it puts a feather edge on the tire. And as you slide your hand one way across the tire, it'll feel rough and the other way feels smooth. If you feel this on your steer tires, the vehicle's out of alignment because the tire cannot feather itself. Go to page two of the handout, and you have a pair of tires that are slightly toed in. The front of the tires are closer together than the back. This causes a toe-in feathering. The feather edge is aimed in on both front tires. As you slide your hand in, it's smooth. You pull it back out, it's rough. Smooth in, toe in. The bottom image shows two tires that are slightly toed out. They're duck-footed sliding down the road and causes a feather edge to aim out on both front tires. It'll feel rough going in and smooth coming out. Smooth out, smooth in. If both tires feel the same, you have a toe problem. Now wait a minute, I took the truck to the alignment shop. They put it on their big fancy rack. They gave me a printout, and the printout says the toe's correct. But the tire says it's not. Which one should you believe? Well, I brought the vehicle in here to fix the tires, not the printout. So I'm gonna believe the tire. But how did the machine make the mistake? Every front end that I've ever checked, brand new or used, has a certain amount of play in the front end parts. And as you drive down the road with the truck, the drag that builds up on the tires pulls the tire out. Now, when you put it on a conventional alignment rack with turn plates, the tires relax. And when you jack it up, everything relaxes. You mount the instruments, dial out the runout, set it back down on the free-floating turn plates, and you measure the toe. But you have not reintroduced the drag into the tires when you did it. So the toe you get on the turn plates is not the same toe you get when you're driving. That's where the mistake comes in. Now, let's say you've got a truck that has toe-in wear on one front tire, but toe-out wear on the other front tire. Well, we go to page three of our handout, and we find that tends to come from the drive axles. If they're slightly out of alignment, they will tend to push the truck to the right. The driver will turn the steering tires back to the left, and as he slides them down the road, you get toe-in wear on the right front tire, toe-out wear on the left front tire. This is a classic drive axle alignment problem. Now wait a minute, we took it to the alignment shop and they said it's within factory spec. All right, I want to turn the page around. We've got a nice blank page. And I have a pen, and we're going to make believe this is a drive axle on this rectangular truck. Now the factory says that dead straight ahead is perfect. But because you can't get it dead straight ahead all the time, they allow it to aim a little to the left or a little to the right, and that's still within acceptable standards. How did the factory come up with these standards? How did they decide how much left and right is acceptable? Do you think they built a bunch of trucks and put incrementally different numbers in them and drove them to see which ones drove right or wore tires right? What they did was they found out how close could they set the axle to dead straight ahead in 7 to 9 minutes while the truck went down the assembly line at the factory. Because they got to build 250 trucks a day, they don't have a half hour to waste. Now, let's say that this drive axle is aimed slightly left within factory spec. Which way is the truck going to go? Well, it's going to go to the right, like an outboard motorboat. If you aim the motor left, boat goes right. So I can be in factory spec, aimed left, and have a right pull. What if it's aimed dead straight ahead? Which way is the front of the truck going to go? Well, it should go straight ahead, and I agree, on flat roads. But we don't drive on flat roads. We drive on 2% crown roads and let the water run off. So the truck's always driving on a side hill. And you aim the drive axle dead straight ahead, it still wants to fall off the hill. And the driver's going to compensate, and he's going to have a right pull complaint. We've learned from experience doing this that if you aim that drive axle just about a 32nd of an inch shim to the right, it tends to push the truck against the crown of the road, the truck drives straight, and the tires wear flat. There is a magic window in there. What if you aim it too far to the right? Well, the logic would say it should go to the left. But in fact, what happens is when you aim it too far to the right, now the drive axle is aiming down the crown of the road, and the truck still pulls to the right. So whichever way you misalign it, it tends to go to the right until you hit that magic spot just slightly right. Now, there are more complications when you add a second drive axle to a truck. Now I've got a tandem. And with a tandem, if they're not in a line with each other and they're narrower on the passenger side, that cone they form, like laying down a tapered Dixie cup and rolling it, will tend to cone the truck off to the right. You never want the narrow side on the passenger side of the truck. We cover this kind of stuff in the training on how to combine tandem alignment and single drive axle alignment. Now, I've talked about tow problems where both front tires are towed in or towed out. I've talked about drive axle alignment problems where one steer tire shows tow in and one steer tire shows tow out. But what about a truck that only wears out one front tire? Well, if we go to page 4 of our handout, we'll see a pair of steer tires that are slightly towed out, combined with a drive axle that is going to the right. Now the right front tire, because it's towed out, is going right. And it wears nice and flat and good. And all the wear shows up in the left front tire because with its toe out, it's dragging sideways. If you have a pair that are towed in too much and the drive axle's pushing you right. Now the left front tire, because it's towed in, is going right. It's happy. And all the wear shows up on the outside edge of the right front tire. So by combining a toe problem and a rear problem, I can make one front tire wear bad. These feathered wear patterns exist on 70% of the trucks driving up and down the road today. We have to get the toe right and the drives right because that's 70% of our tire wear problems.